In this video, we'll consider these three objectives. The focus will be on how regulatory bodies, deregulation, and direct provision can impact the allocation of resources in an attempt to correct complete or partial market failure. Regulatory bodies are government entities authorized to supervise and regulate behavior in a specific area of the economy. For example, part of the responsibility of the U.S. Federal Trade Commission is to prevent anti-competitive business practices. One thing they may do is look into mergers to examine whether the combined company would unreasonably restrain competition. If it was determined to be so, then the merger may be blocked. Additionally, they may determine that a firm is behaving in an uncompetitive manner and rule against such behavior. A great example of the FTC's intervention was the Microsoft case. I will quote from the article on the FTC's website. Microsoft was found to have a monopoly over operating system software for IBM-compatible personal computers. Microsoft was able to use its dominant position in the operating systems market to exclude other software developers and prevent computer makers from installing non-Microsoft browser software to run with Microsoft's operating system software. Specifically, Microsoft illegally maintained its operating systems monopoly by including Internet Explorer, the Microsoft Internet browser, with every copy of its Windows operating system software sold to computer makers and making it technically difficult not to use its browser or to use a non-Microsoft browser. Microsoft also granted free licenses or rebates to use its software, which discouraged other software developers from promoting a non-Microsoft browser or developing other software based on that browser. These actions hampered efforts by computer makers to use or promote competing browsers and discouraged the development of add-on software that was compatible with non-Microsoft browsers. The court found that although Microsoft did not tie up all ways of competing, its actions did prevent rivals from using the lowest cost means of taking market share away from Microsoft. To settle the case, Microsoft agreed to end certain conduct that was preventing the development of competing browser software. As you can see from the excerpt I've just read, the intervention of the FTC ended some of Microsoft's anti-competitive business behavior. The end result is likely that you're viewing this video on a browser that is not Internet Explorer. Leave a comment about what browser you are using, and we can do an informal survey of web browser usage and see how the FTC ruling has impacted our use of internet browsers. Next up is deregulation, which entails either removing or reducing regulations that are currently in place with the aim of making markets more competitive. This image of a Southwest airline wing is relevant to the discussion, as I'll explain next. In the 1970s, the United States government opened its airways to competition. This was accomplished by removing government controls on fares, routes, and the entry of new airlines. Ticket prices subsequently fell and the quantity of flights consumed rose significantly. The arrival of low-cost carriers flying out of cheaper, smaller airports placed pressure on larger airlines to compete. Thirdly, the government can intervene directly to provide certain goods and services. In the case of public and merit goods, the government will intervene to provide or help provide these goods to the market. Public goods are unlikely to be provided at all, thus causing a missing market. Merit goods are likely to be underprovided, resulting in a less than socially optimal level of output. Public goods are unlikely to be supplied by private enterprises due to the lack of opportunity to make a profit. This is due to their non-excludable nature and that you cannot prevent someone who has not paid for a good from benefiting from it. Ultimately, this would result in missing markets and the government would need to intervene and directly provide such goods. A commonly cited example would be flood defense. Let's consider the case of these five houses on the right. If the owners of the two homes closest to the riverfront invest in flood defenses, the owners of the three homes behind are protected. They can free ride on the decision of the others to invest into such a system. The two homeowners in the front may carefully consider the cost of such provision and decide not to do so. They cannot predict floods, so assume the odds are so low that the investment may not be worth it. Even if we assume they did want to continue with the project, they would need so many permissions to build it and expensive equipment to do so. It may exceed what they are willing to pay. Also, remember the non-rivalrous feature of public goods. You cannot reduce the amount of flood defense available to others if you build a flood defense system as above. In this case, the government is best placed to build and pay for the development of flood defenses. It can collect the funds through tax and develop a system that protects the entire area. Merit goods are likely to be underprovided in the free market. Due to their positive externalities, the government would intervene to provide or subsidize these goods and services to increase their consumption and production. In reality, merit goods are provided by both the public and private sector. If you consider the case for education, consumers will often have a public choice and a private choice. You can attend a private high school or a government-funded school. The aim is that all individuals should have access to an education without necessarily considering price. Offering government-funded schools at no direct cost to the consumer will increase the number of students attending school. In many countries, it is also legally required that children of a certain age attend school. By now, you should have a clear idea of how these three factors can impact the allocation of resources. Leave a comment or question below if you need any help, and I'll do my best to answer. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.